Forward. I began to examine the flip side a few years ago, but in an indirect way. I'm not a medium, not a psychic, not a hypnotherapist, just a filmmaker who has written for magazines, trade publications, and a handful of best-selling, that's Amazon, Kindle in their genre, books about the afterlife. For those aware of my books, from Flipside, A Tourist Guide on How to Navigate the Afterlife, It's a Wonderful Afterlife, Further Adventures in the Flipside, to Hacking the Afterlife, Practical Advice from the Flipside, you're well aware of what I've been up to. But for those of you who aren't, in a nutshell, I've been filming people under deep hypnosis for over a decade, more than 50 cases so far, and I've compared their answers to the thousands of cases of Dr. Helen Wambaugh and Michael Newton. This book has excerpts of about 50 interviews with people not under hypnosis who say the same things about the journey. What people say is both consistent and reproducible. I've done 6 of my own deep hypnosis sessions and made a documentary about the research of hypnotherapist Michael Newton and others using deep hypnosis. That was called Flipside, A Journey into the Afterlife. It's available on Amazon and Gaia. The film contains excerpts from a dozen hypnotherapy sessions. I've examined the cases of Dr. Helen Wambaugh. Her books are Reliving Past Lives and Life Before Life. She was a clinical psychologist who did PTSD therapy for Vietnam veterans in the 1970s. During her sessions, she found people would go further than she imagined they could or would. In order to study whether or not their memories of past lives could be accurate, she applied a scientific approach to her research. She didn't ask people to go to a specific past life memory, but recruited groups of people and gave them options of different time periods to explore. 100 years ago, 250 years ago, 500, etc. The people doing the session made the choice of what lifeline, if any, they would explore. Then she would conduct 4 2-hour sessions, 8 hours per day, where she would do a group hypnosis session and have them all report whatever they remembered. She tossed out results that appeared biased. She focused on people who remembered how they lived, what their houses looked like, what kind of clothing they wore, and what kind of tools they used, including their eating utensils. She did this because there are historical records regarding those items, and they aren't often examined while under hypnosis. She could compare what people remembered versus the scientific record of that era. So, if a person was using a 2-pronged fork, or a 3-pronged fork, or a 4-pronged fork, and it matched the time and era, they wouldn't be eliminated from the study. She focused on architecture, how houses were built, clothing was manufactured, the kinds of food people ate, etc. That way, she could compare what they remembered with the actual, verifiable, historical record. She found that only 1% of her clients could be eliminated for reasons she didn't feel it held up to the rest and fell into categories. From these data sets, she reported 2,000 clients who could recall previous lifetimes, could compare their reports, and see the consistencies in relation to historical facts. In Michael Newton's work, he estimated 7,000 subjects over his 40-year career and 4 books. First publishing in 1994, he used a direct approach, asking people to recall, quote, a lifetime that had some influence on their current lifetime. He then mapped out what they said about the journey and compared it to thousands of cases he had gathered. What he found was that his clients were consistent about the journey, and what I found by comparing Wambaugh's data with Newton's reports, they matched in terms of hallmarks of the so-called afterlife. So-called because people consistently say we're, quote, fully conscious prior to incarnation, that we choose our lifetimes, bring about a third of our conscious energy to that lifetime, so we are semi-conscious while on the planet. And then, when the body fails, that conscious energy returns, quote, back home, that's the term they all use, to reconnect with the conscious energy left behind. So I've spent over 10 years filming people saying the identical things and have put some of those transcripts into my first 4 books. Somewhere along the line, I met Jennifer Schaefer. In the past 5 years, I've been conducting direct interviews with mediums like Jennifer to access people on the flip side who are no longer on the planet.